In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, what a joy today as we celebrate our parish patron feast, not only a parish but our archdiocese patron and also our country India. And also today, what a joy to have Father Antic, Redemptorist priest, and we both happen to be a son of soil. So that way, it's a real joy for us to celebrate this Mass along with you and pray for you. We are also there in the Advent season. Let us not forget that. As I just came to the altar, I saw those beautiful candles. My dear brothers and sisters, those candles has got a beautiful meaning in it. It is a 4 weeks, which mentions a 4 candles, and in the center, the white on the Christmas day, and the green around those Advent candle to indicate a life is everlasting and is evergreen. And you can find there's a 1 candle with a pink color. It will be on the next Sunday. That Sunday, that is next Sunday, is called Gautatum Sunday. That is a joyful Sunday. What is a joyful Sunday? Why we are supposed to be wearing violet? Even though there is an expectation that Mother Mary is going to give a birth, at the same time, there is also a little anxiety, you know, whether the child is going to have a normal delivery or is going to be everything okay. So there is some sort of a mixed feeling to indicate that one pink candle is there. And above all, my dear brothers and sisters, till this December 16th, all the readings, even today's reading, will focus on the second coming of Jesus Christ. And after 16th evening onwards, when we look at the reading, it is the first coming where the Jesus was born as a child, and connected to that, those readings will be there. And also from December 16 onwards, we celebrate the Novena to the Christmas. How many of us celebrate Novena today? How many of us knows this? Francis we know, Mary's we know, so many other feasts, saints we know. But there is a beautiful Novena for the Christmas also. So like this, today there is a plenty of joy in the church as we have a multiple celebration. To receive that celebrated faith, to receive that blessing in us, the one thing which stops us, our sinfulness. Let us pause for a moment and ask pardon from God for all his shortcomings and failures. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, if I ask Blessed Mary the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
Gloria, Gloria in excelsis Deo. Gloria, Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Jesus, Savior of God, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away our sins, O Lord, have mercy on us all.
Gloria, Gloria in excelsis Deo. Gloria, Gloria in excelsis Deo.
At the Father's right hand, Lord, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, and you alone the Lord.
Let us pray. O God, who through the preaching of St. Francis Xavier won many peoples to yourself, grant that the heart of the faithful may burn with the same zeal for the faith, and the Holy Church may everywhere rejoice in an abundance of offspring. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Isaiah prophesied that Messiah would be equipped by the gift of the Spirit with wisdom, understanding, counsel, might, knowledge, and fear of the Lord. So let us listen the first reading.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. A shoot springs from the stalk of Jesse, a scion thrusts from his roots. On him the Spirit of the Lord rests, a spirit of wisdom and insight, a spirit of counsel and power, a spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. He does not judge by appearances. He gives no verdict on hearsay, but judges the wretched with integrity, and with equality gives a verdict for the poor of the land. His word is a rod that strikes the ruthless. His sentences bring death to the wicked. Integrity is the lion's cloth around his waist, faithfulness the belt around his hips. The wolf lives with the lamb, the panther lies down with the kid, calf and lion cub feed together, with a little boy to lead them. The cow and the bear make friends, their young lie down together. The lion eats straw like the ox, the infant plays over the cobra hole in the viper's lair. The young child puts his hand. They do not hurt, no harm, on all my holy mountain. For the country is filled with the knowledge of the Lord, as the water swells the sea. That day the root of Jesse shall stand as a signal to the peoples. It will be sought out by the nations, and its home will be glorious. The word of the Lord.
Thanks
Your response shall be, in his days justice shall flourish and peace till the moon fails. In his days justice shall flourish and peace till the moon fails. O God, give your judgment to the king, to a king's son your justice, that he may judge your people in justice and your poor in right judgment. Your response? In his days justice shall flourish and peace till the moon fails. In his days justice shall flourish and peace till the moon fails. He shall rule from sea to sea, from the great river to earth's bounds. Your response? In his days justice shall flourish and peace till the moon fails. For he shall save the poor when they cry, and the needy who are helpless. He will have pity on the weak and save the lives of the poor. Your response? In his days justice shall flourish and peace till the moon fails. May his name be blessed forever and endure like the sun. Every tribe shall be blessed in him. All nations bless his name. Your response? In his days justice shall flourish and peace till the moon fails.
Paul tells us that Scripture and Christ are the two main pillars of Christian hope. In Christ, our yearning is fulfilled. Let us listen to the second reading.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Everything that was written long ago in the Scriptures was meant to teach us something about hope. The examples Scripture gives of how people who did not give up were helped by God. And may He who helps us when we refuse to give up help you all be tolerant with each other, following the example of Christ Jesus, so that united in mind and voice, you may give glory to God the Father, our Lord Jesus Christ. It can only be God's glory then for you to treat each other in same friendly way as Christ treated you. The reason Christ became the servant of circumcised Jews was not only so that God could faithfully carry out the promises made to the patriarchs, it was also to get the pagans to give glory to God for his mercy. As Scripture says in one place, "For this I shall praise you, coming among these pagans and give and sing your name." The word of the Lord. Kindly stand for the gospel.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Blessed be the name of the Lord now and forever, from the rising of the sun unto its going down, may the name of God be praised. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In due course, John the Baptist appeared. He preached in the wilderness of Judea, and this was his message. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is close at hand. This was to the man the prophet Isaiah spoke of when he said, a voice cries in the wilderness, prepare a way for the Lord, make his path straight. This man, John, wore a garment made of camel hair with a leather belt around his waist, and his food was locusts and wild honey. Then Jerusalem and all Judea and the whole Jordan district made their way to him. And as they were baptized by him in the river Jordan, they confessed their sins. But when he saw a number of Pharisees and Sadducees coming for baptism, he said to them, brood of vipers, who warned you to fly from the retribution that is coming? But if you are repentant, produce the appropriate fruit, and do not presume to tell yourselves, we have Abraham for our father. Because I tell you, God can raise children for Abraham from these stones. Even now, the axe is laid to the roots of the trees, so that any tree which fails to produce good fruit will be cut down and thrown on the fire. I baptize you in water for repentance. But the one who follows me is more powerful than I am, and I am not fit to carry his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fan is in his hand. He will clear his threshing floor and gather his wheat into the barn, but the chaff he will burn in a fire that will never go out. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Few years back, in one of our archdiocese and parish, there was a lot of problem was going on, plenty. So one of the Saturday, I remember, there was an emergency meeting. And I was also called for that emergency meeting to give my opinion as an administrator of Archdiocese of Bangalore. And in that meeting, all big heads were there, both intellectually powerful. And when the meeting was going on, how to sort it out, because tomorrow, that is Sunday, is going to be a big issue. When each one was suggesting one or the other thing, I told the members, why can't we have immediately after the Mass, just before the final blessing, expose the Blessed Sacrament. Keep it in the altar. He will look after. The reaction from the members was, at once they told me, this is not a time to joke. We are seriously discussing. I was shocked, and people started to laugh at me. We never wanted our God to interfere in our life. We wanted to attend everything, maybe Mass or whatever the pilgrim, Navina, whatever it is. But we wanted to keep our God where He is, don't interfere in my life. Look at this man, Francis Xavier. Such a wealthy man. Even today, if you go and see his house, it is a castle, huge. You'll be getting surprised to see his house, like this parish. Imagine the wealth his parents or he would have had in the 15th century. And his father happens to be a finance officer in Spain, to the king. And well educated, and he was also an advocate. And all they wanted Francis Xavier to go and do his highest studies in France. Somehow his father was so attached to the France that so he names his son as a Francis. Not based on any saints, because he had some love for the France, the country France, he named Francis Xavier as a Francis. And this man, young man, handsome, sportsman, he was also served 1 year in military. Imagine his fitness, how handsome he'll be there. And he goes to this university with big ambition. And his family member also got a big plan for him. He goes and begins his studies. All what happens is, he happens to meet one man there, Ignatius of Loyola. With the one word, if you gain the whole world and lose your soul, what is the profit you are going to gain? Look at this man, Francis. He allowed that moment God to interfere in his life. Francis never told, "This is none of your business. I come to do my studies. My father has got a big ambition and my whole family is having a big expectation and I don't want all this." Instead of telling all this, he just allowed God to interfere in his life. And God interfered in such a way, he became a priest. After some times, he's supposed to be going around Spain, Portugal, for the preaching. And one day, Ignatius of Loyola calls Francis and tells him, "You are going to travel to India." When? Within 24 hours, you are going to take up your journey. 24 hours. I still remember when I was there in Basilica as assistant, Archbishop called me on 31st of December evening and is telling me, "You have been transferred. When? Tomorrow, pack up and come to Bishop's house." Whenever I go through this Francis incident, I just remember. But this man, imagine, 13 months travel. Nothing. Within 24 hours, what preparation he can do? But one good thing is, the king of Portugal makes him as an ambassador or nuncio and send him to India. And 13 months travel, overnight, without any preparation, he just says yes. And second time, this man allows God to interfere in his life. He never said, "Oh, I got a dream to stay here, preach to these people, how to go around Spain, Portugal, oh, lot of things." Never said. Allowed God to interfere. He travels and comes to India. Imagine, even today, somebody is coming from Europe or Spain to India, how much they have to be struggling. Today, every one of us speak English, no problem. Imagine this man does not know any language, except maybe the Spanish, or maybe he would have learned English or French little bit since he was there in France, and coming to India in the coastal belt, the language, all vernacular language. How much you would have struggled. He never told those people, "Come on, first you learn my language. then I'll preach. Instead of this, one man said, I will learn your language and I'll preach for you. And every day and night used to practice this pronunciation, those, you know, the sounds and all, and next day morning used to take a catechism. And he begins to travel right from Goa to all the coastal belt. Today, the coastal belt alone, especially when you go towards the Tamil Nadu, the coastal belt alone, they have 43% Catholics. How it can happen? One man, once again, allowed God to interfere. God interfered in such a way, made him to travel, speak about the word of God, speak about Jesus Christ, meet every people, even the different culture, language, different weather. Imagine how much you would have struggled just at the age of 35 is doing all these things. With all that, he aims to go to Japan. Once again, lot of struggle he goes through, but ultimately, somehow, he allows God to interfere in his life and he travels to Japan. He stays hardly few months there, and later on we see, within a year, 3 lakh people embracing Christianity. 3 lakh people. Once again, my dear brothers and sisters, it is said he was finding very difficult, so hard to learn the Japanese language, something very new. But all he had, the mission, Jesus, everywhere, Jesus. And he went and preached. And at last he wants to go to China. Somewhere that was another ambition he has, gets somehow to travel to China and preach the word of God. He begins to learn the Chinese language, goes to the border, and he pays the money to those people somehow to allow him inside, because they were stopping all these Portuguese people or Spain, all those European people to enter the country. And one man takes the money and promises, don't worry, I'll come back and take you to China. That man never comes back. This man, Francis, waits, and at last he dies there in Morocco. My dear brothers and sisters, when we look at the life of this St. Francis Xavier, it is said he used to go in a barefoot, carrying along with him one habit and also one surplice, that's all, and the cross in his hand. And today, so many of them are Christian because this one man preached. All I wanted to tell you, my dear brothers and sisters, this one man allowed God to interfere, and look at the changes what he brought. And at last, this one man in the border of China did not allow Francis to do God's work with that stop. Till today, even today, Bible is, we cannot carry inside China publicly. It's a forbidden product, forbidden book, till today. If that one man would have cooperated with Francis Xavier, and if Francis Xavier had entered China, today imagine the Catholic world, the Christian world. And this is what happens in our own life, my dear brothers and sisters. Allow Jesus, allow God to interfere in your life. Don't tell him, Lord, this is not your work, this is not your business, be away, stay back, don't come. The time you say, and you think, or we think, we are quite smart enough, we know everything, and ultimately we are failure in the life. Allow him only once, my dear brothers and sisters, only once. Tell him, Lord, come to my life. You do whatever you want. I'll sign blank in a white paper. You write whatever you want about my life. And see the changes. But at the same time, let us not be that other person, the one Chinese, who became a big obstacle to the God's work. We may be saying, one man, Father, I'm only single individual. This individual single man, Francis Xavier, could do so many work, and other individual single man could stop so much work. So every individual matters. Today we should ask ourselves, my dear brothers and sisters, who we are. Are we this saint, St. Francis Xavier, who want to allow God to interfere in our life? Are we those other chains who tell ourselves, we don't want God to interfere in my life? Please stand. Let us profess our faith.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us pray to the Lord Jesus that we may prepare his deeper coming in the church and the world of today. Let us say, come, Lord Jesus, delay no longer. Come, Lord Jesus, delay no longer.
Lord Jesus, help our leaders, Pope Francis, Archbishop Bernard, and all in positions of authority, that by their gentleness, understanding, and serving love, they may reflect better your face. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus, delay no longer.
Lord Jesus, dispose all leaders and people in power to bring your peace and your justice to a world dominated by strife and exploitation. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus, delay no longer.
Lord Jesus, make our Christian communities pay more attention to the sick and the elderly, the unemployed and the lonely. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus, delay no longer.
Lord Jesus, teach each and every one of us to free ourselves from greed and the hunger for power, that we may be more open to the people around us. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus, delay no longer.
Lord Jesus, help all of us here in the Eucharist to prepare ourselves for the celebration of Christmas, that we may do away with all that stands in the way of your deeper coming in our hearts and in our community. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus, delay no longer.
O God, on the feast day of our patron, Saint Francis Xavier, who by his preaching and miracles made people turn to Christ, pray for us that our hearts too may be filled with love for Christ and may always praise you. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus, delay no longer. We bring before the Lord our own personal needs, our community needs, and we pray for our parish and every family who belong to this parish and who belong to the patron of the Archdiocese and our parish, that we may be inflamed with zeal to bear witnesses to Christ like St. Francis Xavier. We pray to the Lord. Come, Lord Jesus, delay no longer. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, fill us with the joy of your presence. Stay with us now and forever. Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, these offerings we bring in commemoration of St. Francis Xavier, and grant that as he journeyed to distant land out of longing for the salvation of the soul, so we too, bearing effective witness to the gospel, may with the brothers and sisters eagerly hasten towards you through Christ alone. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Francis Xavier, you bid the Church rejoice, so to you strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answers to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Beneath this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that he held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and bread of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Bernard, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with her spouse, Blessed Joseph, with the blessed apostles, Saint Francis Xavier, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Father in heaven, holy be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us to that test, but deliver us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostle, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with
your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
This is Jesus Christ, our living God. Today we are called to allow him to interfere in our life. Blessed are those who call to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
compared to Saint Francis Xavier.
Most lovable and loving Saint Francis Xavier, in union with you, I adore the divine majesty, the remembrance of the favors with which God blessed you during your life and of your glory after death, fills me with joy, and I unite with you in offering to him my humble tribute of thanksgiving and praise. I implore you to secure for me, through your powerful intercession, the favor I ask. But if what I ask is not of the glory of God and for the good of my soul, obtain for me what is most convenient for living and dying in the state of grace. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Let us pray. May a mystery, O God, kindle in us that fire of charity with which Saint Francis Xavier burned for the salvation of the soul, so that walking ever more worthy in our vocation, we may obtain with him the reward you have promised to those who labor well in your harvest, through Christ our Lord.
Kindly be seated. On behalf of the parish priest and all the parish clergy, I would like to thank Reverend Father Devadas for having celebrated this feast day Eucharist and breaking the word of God. I'd like to honor him with a shawl and a garland. Once again, a very happy feast, and kindly visit the stall on to your right and the exhibition on to your left.
Please stand. Let us ask the intercession of Our Lady. Hail Mary, full of grace with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Oh.